helpful to write about what you know, and I've lived in Rockland for a long time. It's also, Rockland is a really cool place. There's a lot of cool things that have happened here. There's a lot of cool people that showed up here early on in Rockland's history. And it was an easy thing to do to pick out some of the Rockland history and use it for a book. Matt Rukula came here in the 1800s. So, name ring a bell? Rukula? Yeah? Matt Rukula came to this country and started a granite mine, a granite quarry. And he quarried out a lot of granite. Granite quarry, you've been to probably in the third grade, yeah? Yeah? It's just a big hole in the ground where you cut granite out of the ground and ship it all over the place. Rockland was very important with granite. A lot of the granite that is used in the state capitol in Sacramento and a lot of the granite that's used in the big tall buildings in San Francisco came out of granite mines, and a lot of it came out of Rukula's granite mines. His son Roy is still alive. His son Roy is approaching 100 years old, I think, and he used to be the mayor of Rockland. So your school is named after a pretty cool guy. You're the Quarry Cats, yeah? That's why, because Matt Rukula owned quarries. Parker Whitney's another guy that came to this town and started something cool. You are sitting on Spring Valley Ranch right now. Spring Valley Ranch was 20,000 acres owned by Parker Whitney a long, long time ago. You're sitting on the lower part of it. Most of Rockland is built on Spring Valley Ranch. Probably looked a lot like that when he got here. Now it looks a lot like Rockland. Who's heard of 12 Bridges Road near, out towards Lincoln? Yeah? 12 Bridges Road is named 12 Bridges Road because Parker Whitney built 12 granite bridges on Spring Valley Ranch in the 1800s, in the late 1800s. He probably used granite that came from Rukula's quarry. He built 12 of them. There are 9 of them that we know about. The other 3 were lost somewhere, somehow. He didn't draw a very good map before he put them all. But he made these granite bridges to go over all the streams on Spring Valley Ranch so that he could ride around and drive around in his carriages easily without having to cross a stream every time he wanted to get somewhere. 5 of them are on golf courses, and a couple of them are used every day. Golf carts drive across them every day. 2 of them are at parks. This one right here is at Mansion Oaks Park, right below where his house used to be. And that one over there is at Clover Valley Park. That's the big one. And you can go walk across those. Clover Valley Park Bridge is really cool. If you get a chance, you should go there and check it out. It's really neat. 2 of them are out in fields just getting swallowed up by grass, unfortunately. It would be really cool if somebody decided to save them and reconstruct them. The one at Mansion Oaks Park, they actually took out of a field, took it apart block by block, and put it back together at the park so that they could save it. It'd be nice if somebody did that to the other ones. So that's why 12 Bridges is called 12 Bridges. The Oaks, does that house look familiar? That's the house on the front of the book. That's because I stole the house for the book. The boys in the book live in that house with their parents who know nothing about what they do. And their crazy grandpa visits them, and the book takes place almost entirely at that house. That house was actually Parker Whitney's house. He built it a long time ago. It was a huge mansion, the biggest house in Rockland. And it was called the Oaks. He named his house. Nobody names their house anymore, but he did. He named his house the Oaks. It's not there anymore.